residents of Priam Street in Diamond Village had just about given up hope that their roads and drains would ever be fixed. However, in what many describe as an answer to their prayers, the cabinet had decided to approve a nationwide roads and bridges repairs program. Today, we visited Priam Street, where we got a first-hand look at the progress of the works in the area. Known for having one of the worst roads in the area, and also being one of the longest streets, it was not hard to understand why the residents of Priam Street were overjoyed to see this level of activity taking place at their doorsteps.
I feel real flattered about the road, the drainage, the box drain and whatnot. I feel real up to par because of the attention that Priam Street is getting right now.
Well, I'm happy about it because it was in a real bad condition and the taxis and them are refusing to come in the street. So now that they're fixing it, I am positively sure all the residents are happy about it.
It was learned that prior to the roadworks, there were flooding issues due to a lack of proper drainage, and the residents recalled the number of years and false promises they had to endure before they were assisted.
Since the last, when PNM now came into power, they had resheeted the road and it's a couple years well.
However, the resheeting of the road, which was not completed throughout the street, was not enough.
No, well, the drainage, we didn't have any drains, and the water were going into people's yards and under the building and thing. So now that they do the drains, the water has stopped coming in.
Oh, it was in a mess. Gravel, big potholes, taxis don't come in the street. Some of them raise the fare high because of these holes. You could hardly walk into the street, in and out and whatnot.
We've been waiting about 60 years for this drain. I live in here about 60 years and more. And the drainage is really bad. Water flooding downstairs. Well, I hope that they'll pull out the water now, and it's a good thing. I thank God for the government. They're making a good effort fixing the road. But here wasn't fixed in odd years. So I'm glad that they're building the road and they're putting the drainage. Are we happy about that?
Priam Street has approximately 150 homes and persons from all walks of life who had to deal with the poor conditions of the roads for some time. Mr. Aziz Hussein, who is paraplegic, said he wrote numerous letters and frequented the MP's office to bring some sort of relief to the villagers. Today, though the road is much harder for him to wheel along, he is grateful for the commencement of the works.
I'm glad to know it fixing, and I feel happy about it because I'm in a wheelchair. And the position we in, me and my family, I'm very glad about it. And yes, now I glad to get the road fixed, and I glad to know that they really intend to fix it. Anyhow, you take it, they intend to fix it now, and I'm happy about that.
Aside from the road repairs at Priam Street, there are similar works taking place at adjoining Indar Singh Drive and major developmental activities such as the Poinfortin Highway, which runs parallel to Priam Street, and the nearby UE Penal DB campus, which can clearly be seen.
They're constructing box drain throughout Priam Street, throughout Indar Singh Street here, as well as Kuban Slipper, and they're also redoing the road on Priam Street, the entire road.
He explained that the project started 1 month prior and was expected to be completed in 3 weeks' time. He also stated that there were no issues and that everything was running according to plan.
Residents seem to be very helpful as well as happy with what's going on. As a matter of fact, some of the residents are employees of the contractors who are doing the work over here.
We spoke to one such resident who received employment through this contract.
I feel good about that, because you know I want to be a part of fixing my own road. You understand? Because it was in a state. You understand? I feel pleased to see we're getting some work done inside of here.
The workers were even complimented on the fast pace at which the works are progressing.
Oh, they're working good, very good, regular. They are here from almost dusk to dawn, you know, because some of them are asked them if they're sleeping here.
Some of the residents acknowledged that in its current state, the road posed an inconvenience, while others said they did not mind it at all, as there were better days ahead.
I'm happy for the effort and stuff, but they have to consider that people have their cars. And if you could hear my car, it working like, you know what, I don't want to go against because it's a good thing. It's a good thing for the people here, but then they have to think about if somebody gets sick, the inconvenience if the ambulance have to come in, you know? Sometimes you have to wait 20 to 30 minutes to come out of the street, and it's like real stress.
Well, I had surgery on my knee, so it's kind of hard for me to get out of here because of the taxis, right? And now that the road it is not completed, so it's still kind of hard. So if they will hurry up on it, to do the sheeting, it will be very good.
Yeah, I don't mind because the sacrifice is good. Because if we have waited so much years, donkey years, before we could get it, and if we are getting something done now, I'm very, very appreciated. I will be patient. The villagers are being patient.